Hello and welcome. In this video we will be covering how to calculate the support reactions of a simply supported beam with a uniformly distributed load. By the end of this video you will be able to determine the support reactions of a simply supported beam and use this knowledge to solve similar problems. If we look at the beam we can see that it is 5 meters in length and has supports at either end labelled RA and RB. It has a uniformly distributed load of 80 newtons per meter applied across the whole beam. As the beam is stationary, the forces acting on it must cancel out and it is said to be in equilibrium. Our goal is to find the support reactions at RA and RB. To simplify the problem, we can replace the UDL with an equivalent point load. The magnitude of the equivalent point load for a UDL like this one is equal to the area under the distribution and is located at the centre of the distribution. In this case, we have an 80 newtons per metre load applied over 5 metres. So the equivalent point load would have a magnitude of 400 newtons and would be located at the 2.5 metre point. As we can see, our problem has now become a simply supported beam with a point load in the middle. To determine the support reactions, we will use the method of moments. We begin by taking moments about point RA. Since the distance of the reaction force at RA is zero, the moment of RA must also be zero. Next, we'll calculate the clockwise and anti-clockwise moments. The only clockwise moment we have is caused by the 400 newton load at a distance of 2.5 metres. So total clockwise moments equal 400 times 2.5, which equals 1000 newton metres. The only anti-clockwise moment we have is caused by the support reaction, RB, at a distance of 5 metres. Since the beam is in equilibrium, the clockwise moments must be equal to the anti-clockwise moments. Therefore, we can transpose this equation to find RB by dividing 1000 by 5, which gives us 200 newtons. Due to the symmetry of our arrangement, we could argue that RA is also equal to 200 newtons. But to prove this, let's take moments about point RB. Since the distance of the reaction force at RB is zero, the moment of RB must also be zero. Next, we'll calculate the clockwise and anti-clockwise moments. The only anti-clockwise moment we have is caused by the 400 newton load at a distance of 2.5 metres. So, total clockwise moments equal 400 times 2.5, which equals 1000 newton metres. The only clockwise moment we have is the support reaction RA at a distance of 5 metres. Since the beam is in equilibrium, the clockwise moments must be equal to the anti-clockwise moments, and again, we can transpose this equation to find RA by dividing 1000 by 5, which gives us 200 newtons. To check our calculation, we can sum the vertical forces up and down. The sum of the upward forces, RA plus RB, is 200 plus 200, which equals 400 newtons. And the sum of the downward forces is the applied load, which is 400 newtons. Since the sum of the upward and downward forces cancel out to zero, our calculation is correct. We hope you found this video helpful in understanding how to calculate support reactions of a simply supported beam with a uniformly distributed load. Remember to break down the calculation steps into smaller parts and use visual aids to help solve similar problems in the future. Thank you for watching.